Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint. In my previous video, I had explained you how to set rehearse timings for each of the slides separately so that you don't need to click the mouse button or the arrow keys of your keyboard again and again in order to change the slides. In this video, I will be explaining you a very similar kind of feature like the previous one, but it is more advanced and can be more useful to you. Go to the Slideshow tab and here you can find the option named Record Slideshow. So this option is the immediate neighbor of rehearse timings and they are more or less similar to each other. The major difference is that the Record Slideshow feature is capable of recording the slide timings along with recording the narration, ink and laser point gestures for your presentation. This means that you can just plug in your microphone and click this option and whatever you speak over there will get recorded in your slide. Let me just show this to you. When you click this option, you can either start the recording from beginning of your presentation or from a specific particular slide. The whole of the interface of this feature is similar to the rehearse timings feature of PowerPoint, except that this feature is recording your narration in the background along with recording the slide and animation timings. Just play your slideshow and keep on speaking the narration in your microphone. When you end the recording, you can see that a sound icon appears in the slide. This means that your voice has been recorded in the slide. You can go to the slide sorter view and see that a separate timing has been assigned to each of the slide. So you can now just press the F5 button to play your slideshow and you can just sit back and relax since PowerPoint will automatically change the slides on its own and play the narration which you have recorded in your slides. So this becomes very useful in those cases where you are not physically present over the place where you are to present the slideshow to your audience. Moreover, this feature is very useful when you are to export your presentation as a video format, which I will be explaining in detail in my next video. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.